I don't mean to be rude, but like, what is this? Why have they done this? When you look at the front of this house, it's this big weird wall of boxy, horrible, awful, terrible, bad house. And I like the idea of this house. I think the style of it could be kind of fun. I love the green windows, and I love the, university house kind of cramped nature of it. But man, isn't it just disappointing? And so, because of that, I'm gonna go ahead and try and renovate this house today and turn it into more one of a house that I think fits more realistically as a university house, but also make it a little bit less weird and boxy on the outside because this is just a horrible wall of doom. The window placement is tragic. It's offensive, honestly. The window placement, I can't deal with this. So we'll have to make some minor adjustments, but like, what's that? Come on. Seriously, come on. Anyway, let's get started. All right, let's do this. You'll see the first thing I did was add a bump out to the front of the house because I figured it just looked so weird and flat and it needed to be like pulled out somehow. So I made it match the back of the house with that like little bump out and more roofing there just to kind of make it look a little bit less weird and flat and like one big giant wall. And it also added more space downstairs so I could fit more bedrooms because right now this house is only two bedrooms. It's got four beds, but it's just two bedrooms. And so I changed it to have five bedrooms and they're all single bedrooms because I figured like most of my dorms that I built all had double shared rooms, but if you want to have like a single bedroom, you could live off campus or well, on campus, but not in a dorm in like more of a house type space. Kind of what I figured would be like a sorority house if you wanted it to be. I'm not gonna make any like affiliation to this build because I figured like if you want to play a sorority house, like you can make it match your own gameplay, but at least it has a house with five bedrooms, so you can kind of fit a bunch of Sims. The original house only has four spaces for Sims, this one has five, so there's that. You can also add more beds if you wanted to, but there's five bedrooms, all single beds, and also everyone has a desk and a dresser and all of that. The old house didn't even have desks in all the rooms, which I think is really sad to like have a whole house and not even have a desk. Like that's the one thing a university student needs. Like you kind of need a desk in university, you know? Like there are a couple requirements for this and I feel like desks are a requirement. Like you it's just gotta happen. But anyway, I added desks into the rooms. I love how small the house is. There isn't like a study area or anything anymore. There's a kitchen and dining space, a living room, and also like a rec room type area that has a ping pong table and a computer because I figured one, college is expensive and like you might not have a computer. So I put one down for you. Don't worry. There's actually two, I think. And I tried to keep the house looking kind of closed off like it used to before because I wanted to match that original style but also just make it look a little bit nicer. It only uses University in the base game, so of course you can download it and plan if you have the pack. Guys, I must clarify, my Simsy save is not done yet. I'm going away for Thanksgiving this week, and also I am so sick and I haven't finished it yet. I'm still missing two houses, the Pleasant House and the one next door. I haven't done those yet, so the save file isn't finished and out. But if you want to play with the Simsy save, you can get the last one. So I'll link that down below. But of course, just like get that one and place the lots yourself. I'm not gonna make any new Sims this time either, because I figured like I don't like the fact that when you try and move into a dorm, it doesn't warn you when there's already a Sim living there and it puts them in your household, because sure you can delete them or remove them or whatever, but like I don't want to have to delete Becca and her friend. Like just stop living in my dorm. Why are they in my household now? It's so weird and annoying. So I'm not gonna make any new Sims to fill this save file up this time. I feel like the town doesn't need anyone else. It auto-populates pretty well too, so we should be okay. It's very frustrating how this system works. But I must clarify again, I usually do face cam in all of my videos. And this build, as you might be noticing, does not have face cam. And if you knew what I looked like right now, you would not want face cam. You would absolutely refuse to have me show my face on camera right now. I don't look that bad, but I look pretty bad. Like no makeup, just took a shower, my hair is wet. Like I'm breaking out pretty bad. Like we're going through it right now. So I decided to not do face cam today for this build. I'm finishing pre-recording. My flight's tomorrow to visit my grandparents. So I'm trying to like get some videos out. This is my last one I have to record, but we're working through it, guys, okay? We're getting there. Finals is, they're hitting us hard, and Thanksgiving is ruining my life, and we're just, again, we're going through it. So bear with me. But I did stream this build. I had a lot of fun doing this one because it was kind of a fun change because I think I made a big difference with the house and I still kept it like very similar to how it used to be, which is my goal always with these renovations is to kind of like keep the original nature of the build but fix it up a little bit so it's more useful to play in. And I think I achieved that with this one. And I streamed it. I stream every day on Twitch. That's twitch.tv/lilsimsy if you're interested. I know you are. Please follow me on Twitch. But I also post my VODs on More Simsy, my second channel. channel. VOD means video on demand. My stream re-uploads, basically. So if you missed the stream, you can watch it on my second channel. Guys, I don't mean to beg for subscribers, but, like, I got, like, 80-something K on the second channel. I want a plaque so bad. I know we're, like, kind of a ways away. We're a big ways away from a plaque on that channel, but, God, I want a plaque so bad. I already have a plaque for my main channel, not to flex, but, like, at 100,000 subscribers, you get a plaque sent to you by YouTube with your name on it, and they change how the plaques look. So I have one old plaque for Lil Simsy, and I want a new plaque for more Simsy. I want a plaque. Please subscribe to me on YouTube. Let me get a plaque that says more Simsy on it. Like, it wouldn't that be great if I had my live stream re-upload channel get a plaque? It, like, there's just a lot of beauty in that, okay? It's so dumb. It doesn't deserve it. It's just straight re-uploads of my streams. But if you miss anything and you want to watch them back, you can always do it there. And I stream a lot. So, like, and I want a plaque. I'm not kidding. That would be the best Christmas gift ever. If we do, like, an ultimate campaign for more Simsy to get 100K and I get a plaque, oh, it would make my day. It would make my year. Seriously, I'm so sick right now. I've been so sick for weeks. If you want to make me feel better, all you have to do is subscribe to my second channel on YouTube. Anyway, this build doesn't actually have a kitchen, technically, because you still can't have a stove on this lot. And, like, it looks like a house, but it's still the university housing lot. So the game sees this as being a dorm. So I feel like, in my head, I thought it was a house, and that it was different from the dorms that are, like, the dorms on campus. And this is still on campus, and it's still a dorm, as far as the game is concerned. So you can't place stoves here, which is kind of annoying, because I wanted to have one here. It's one thing in, like, a dorm building, but this is supposed to be a house, and I can't have a stove. So I was a little bit bothered, but it's fine. There's still a kitchenette, so your Sims can come here and, like, make microwaved meals. And there's a coffee pot, so if you want to, like, get some coffee, you can. But also, your Sims can go and get the food from the commons and stuff easily. But there isn't a stove, but there is a kitchen space and also a table, which could function as a good spot to do homework, to be honest. I'm just saying. But I kind of made the house look a little bit fancier than I originally intended. I feel like this house definitely gets, like, when I change the color scheme a little bit more, it sort of gets, like, this awful 70s vibe. And people in my chat were like, hey, this doesn't fit the vibe of the house. Like, it's this kind of old cottage. You made it all 70s inside. But here's my theory, right? It's an old cottage built in, like, 1902, okay? They renovated it recently, but, like, recently is, like, 1974. And so it's, like, updated, sure, in air quotes, but it hasn't been updated since 1974. So the inside, like, the actual furnishing of most of the downstairs and, like, the furnishing and the decorations on the walls and, you know, the colors of the tile, the kitchen hasn't been remodeled since 1974. So it's definitely a very outdated interior, but the bedrooms are all, like, full of IKEA furniture. So it's like they built the furniture in 2005, but the house was remodeled in the 70s. So it's kind of like over time, it's been adjusted ever so slightly. And I think that is very realistic in my head, like to have these old dorm buildings that they've kind of like slowly remodeled as they needed to. And they have, you know, a little bit of updated furniture, but it's also not new or nice by any means. They bought it from like in bulk from some mass supply store. It's all the same, but at least the beds are different colors. Okay, I did do that. My chat was like, oh my god, Kayla, why are they all blue? And I was like, guys, they're not gonna be blue forever. I'm gonna change the colors of my swear. I'm gonna make each one a different theme. It's gonna be so cute. And honestly, one of the people, it's like one of the smallest rooms. It's that square bedroom on the first floor, but it's right next to the bathroom and right next to the kitchen. That's the spot. If you're gonna play in this house, that's the one you want because it's right next to everything. Like, being upstairs is nice and all, but like there's a bathroom up there. The kitchen isn't up there. There's a tiny bedroom in the front of the house. Like, that's not where you wanna be. Pick the one downstairs. Get the one next to the kitchen and the bathroom. That's exactly where you need to be. Although in real life, I feel like that's gonna be not very quiet or good for sleeping because your idiot roommates are going to be so loud and annoying. I think ideally the one on the right side of the upstairs is probably the most quiet because there aren't any bedrooms below you or above you and like it's kind of on its own side of the house. That's the spot maybe. Not as close to things. It isn't as convenient, but at least it'll be quiet because I don't trust these kids. College students are loud and obnoxious and they can't be trusted. I had a roommate who showered at 4 a.m. every single day and she used to blast TV show episodes in the shower because she would like watch TV in the shower but play it super loud so she could hear it. So it would come on like blasting at 4 a.m. her TV shows and her shower and it was so loud. The shower was terrible in my dorm and it was so loud and like I woke up many times to this. College students are inconsiderate and loud, and I just don't trust them. I'm sure you don't either. I'm still a student, so I can say that. It's allowed, okay? It's allowed and it's loud. You know what I mean? I kind of wish that they had a sort of system like in City Living, how you have those neighbors that start doing terrible things and coming out in their underwear and stuff. Unbelievable, but also kind of fitting, I feel like. I mean, your roommates do invite over their girlfriends, boyfriends, and friends and stuff, and they kiss in front of you, which is absolutely shameful. How dare they kiss near me? I will not stand for this kind of sinning, okay? In my Let's Play, I tried to steal someone's boyfriend. My roommate had, like, it said roommate's boyfriend, and I watched him, like, there, but he didn't actually kiss anyone when I was there, so I couldn't tell who he was supposed to be dating. And then I asked if he was single, and he was like, yeah, I'm actually seeing someone. But now he's not seeing them anymore, so I don't really know what happened to him and the roommate, or which roommate it was, but I kind of want to steal my roommate's boyfriend in my Let's Play. I think it's kind of fun. Like, I love that I can do that in this game. In The Sims 3, roommates did not have that interesting of lives. It's kind of cool that they do that in this one, because they invite people over, and they have stuff going on, and that's more exciting to actually have, like, lively roommates instead of just random Sims. They're random Sims, but at least they have lives, to an extent, which I enjoy. It means a lot to me. Can I complain for a second about my day tomorrow and what my life's gonna be like for the rest of the week and also next week? Because this week is Thanksgiving in America. I have this week off of school, and then next week is my finals week, which when you're a history major, translates to the week of like 8 million papers being due. I only have one exam, and it's not even in history class. It's in my anthropology class about mummies, but I don't have any other exams. I just have big papers due, which is, you know, it'd be like that when you take a major like this, where it's like all writing based, but I'm so stressed. I have these big projects all due next week, and I'm gonna be gone with my grandparents this week, and like, well, most of the time Thanksgiving is like, oh, it's a break, you can spend all week writing. I'm gonna be at my grandparents' house, my very elderly grandparents who I never see. They're turning 90 this year, and I like want to spend this holiday with them, but I need to write so badly. So like tomorrow on the plane, I'm gonna crank out one of my papers. I've already written most of it, so I think I can finish it on the time in the time allotted, but it's like a 3-hour flight to Chicago and then a 4.5-hour drive to their house from the Chicago airport, because they live in the middle of nowhere, Illinois. So that's my day tomorrow, is leaving early, going to the airport the Wednesday before Thanksgiving, which is possibly the worst travel day imaginable, the day before Thanksgiving. Absolute nightmare. So I'll catch you guys later. I'm gonna have a good day tomorrow, and my poor cat has to go visit my parents, like to my parents' house, because my parents' neighbors are gonna watch their cats, and so she's gonna go back there to, like, you know, have a safe place to stay and people to watch her. But she hates my parents' house, so I feel bad for her already. Today, I went out and I bought her toys and, like, special canned cat food. She usually eats canned cat food, but, like, she only has, like, you know, I buy, like, one box of it, and so it's, like, 4 different flavors. But I bought her a couple special flavors, like, different ones for, like, special meals when we get back, so I can, like, give her stupid special dinner and make myself feel better about abandoning her on Thanksgiving. And I bought her treats and toys, but the toys, one of them, it's like one of those feather things we have in The Sims 4, you know, like you can play with your cats, but it's like a stick basically, and it has on the end of it a long string with like little felt light bulbs, like Christmas lights. And so it's just like a Christmas themed stupid string toy for your cat to play with, and it's so funny. I love it. It's so dumb and cute, and she doesn't usually play with toys like that. Like, most of the toys she has are things she's stolen from me. Like, I've got, like, little stuffed animals behind me on my shelves that she, like, picks off my shelves and plays with. So she plays with, like, dog toy type stuff. But she liked this one, so I was excited about that. I'm excited to give it to her. I mean, we played with it with her today, but I'm excited to, like, you know, have more time with her and her toys. Merry Christmas, Snap. You're welcome. I love shopping for my cat. It's so dumb. But, like, I love my cat, okay? And I love to buy her presents, and it brings me a lot of joy, and I thought I would update you all. You can also follow her on Instagram. Her name is Snapcatsy on Instagram, like Lil Simsy, but Snapcat and then C-S-I-E, because her name is Snap, and we call her Snapcat. For the record, I coined that nickname long before Snapchat existed. She's 11. I've had her my, like, entire life. I'm 11. I'm just kidding. I'm 20, but I've had her for a long time, and we used to call her Snapcat because it's, like, it kind of, like, Snap and Cat, they sound similar. You know what I'm talking about? No? Okay. Anyway, that's her username on Instagram if you want to follow her. She's very photogenic and beautiful, just like me, obviously. She's more worth a follow than me on Instagram, to be honest, because she probably posts more. I don't post very often on Instagram. Maybe I'll take pictures at my grandparents' house. There is literally nothing else to do there, so maybe this is a good chance for me to take some photos. Oh boy. I'm not kidding either. Maybe. Maybe, just maybe, Lil Simsy will make her big comeback on Instagram. I post like once a month. Which is, you know, I'm not like an intrusive follow, you know? I post all the time on YouTube. Like, I'll spam your feeds everywhere. I post every day on both channels of mine. So when you sub to me there, it's a commitment because you're gonna see me everywhere. But on Twitter and Instagram, I like never post. And so when you do get it, it's very highly curated quality content. So I'm worth a follow. I won't spam you. You know, I'm hilarious and beautiful, says the girl who's decided to not do face cam today because it looks so bad. But in my Instagram pics, I'm beautiful. All right, I'm not kidding. It's true. But you'll see, I just finished up a lot of the exterior of the build. I spent a long time putting on that fake ivy and stuff. And basically what that is, it's a debug item from the game, which is one of the best things they've added in a long time. It isn't technically an item in the game, but it comes in debugs. If you type in testing cheats on, and then bb.showhiddenobjects, and then bb.showliveeditobjects, you get a whole world of new content. It unlocks, like, all of the items from the scenery in the world. So you get a bunch more landscaping things, and also things like this, like prop items, and also the ivy on the walls in Brightchester, which you can now use in your build mode, which they're beautiful. And I think the ivy we have in the game, like the ones that came with Get Together, isn't that nice. Like, it's good and it's versatile, but like, it is just one piece, you know, that one that I'm talking about, and it's kind of hard to make it look varied and nice. But this is like more subtle. You can size it up and down. You can put it on corner pieces. I love this ivy. I've used it in a bunch of builds that I've done this week because it is university, so I can use it everywhere, but it's really nice. And it's technically free because it's like a cheated object. And so it is zero simoleons. So you can place it on your builds and they won't cost anymore. It's like free landscaping. It's very effective. If you're trying to cheat, you can do that. And the thing is, I don't feel cheating for landscaping. I think it's one thing to like cheat to buy your Sims a great stove because it kind of like affects their lives. But cheating when you're playing a challenge to like landscape your house with free debug stuff, like realistically, real life houses, even if they're the cheapest house, they're gonna have like a plant outside. Like, plants grow places. Even if you don't plant them, there's still gonna be like a tree somewhere. And to have a big, giant, empty lot is super unrealistic and just kind of sad. So I don't feel bad cheating in landscaping, you know? It's one thing, like I said, to cheat in like a fancy bed or a fancy TV, but to cheat for your Sims landscaping, like, come on. I can have a tiny house and a nice tree if I want. It's free. It's fine. But you'll see, we're kind of finishing up now. I think it turned out really, really cute. I'm proud of this house. I want to play in it now. I want to make a Sim that lives here. Like, I'm going to go to university again and make a new Sim and play again because I'm that into it. But like I said, I'm going to go. Here's some screenshots if you're interested in seeing the befores and afters. I think it turned out pretty nice. It's on the gallery, by the way. Origin ID is Lil Simsy. Check it out. Download it. Play in it. Okay, I don't know. I'm sorry. I'll go. Subscribe to my second channel. Thank you. Love you. Bye. Should I just beg for followers in every single video from now on? If I'm annoying enough, will I get the subscribers? Is that how it works? Please, subscribe to more Simsy. Please, I'm begging you. Don't make me make a fool of myself. I think I already did, but don't make it worse.